Hello, everybody. I'm Aaron Simmons. This is Philosophy for Where We Find Ourselves, May 2nd, 2020. Today, we are continuing on in our discussion of the problem of evil and possible responses to it. Just a reminder, the problem of evil is the idea that God is all-powerful, God is all-good, and yet there is evil in the world. Over the last few days, we've considered several responses. We've looked at strategies that deny one of the initial premises. We've considered greater good theodicies, whereby God's wisdom is necessitating or allowing evil in ways that make possible an outcome that is ultimately worth the pain. Today, we're going to consider a third strategy, and it's by far the most popular and prominent strategy within the recent philosophical literature. This is the idea of the free will defense. Now, importantly, it's called a defense, not a theodicy, because it is an attempt to try to make sense not of what's true of God, but instead what is possibly true of God in reality, such that these three claims are not inconsistent in the way that we might have thought. So it is a philosophical strategy, not a theological view. We're going to consider this view as articulated by Alvin Plantinga. Alvin Plantinga is a contemporary Christian philosopher, and he articulates the free will defense in the following manner. He simply says, "It is possible that free will is the condition for love, relationships, and personal investment with the divine. If that's the case, then free will is a good that God wants to actualize in the world in order to facilitate those personal engagements. Therefore, free will requires not only that we be able to choose, but that we be able to choose badly. That real free will option means there is risk involved in human history, risk involved in God's creative act, and therefore, when humans make mistakes, when we choose badly, there are consequences to those actions, and those consequences are ultimately the reason that we have so much evil and suffering in the world." Now, this makes tons of sense, of course, relative to the idea of a parent, like we discussed yesterday. If some of the greater good theodicies seem to make it look like God is a negligent parent, we might say that the free will defense makes God look much more like a nurturant parent. God, recognizing the good desired for creation, enables us to be able to choose. Those choices are where real moral life happens. God has abandoned the ability to will the outcome of our choices. In this way, the future becomes open in particular ways, such that we are co-creative with God of the way human history will play out. I find this very compelling, and I find much of this in line with my own theological views called open theism. We've discussed this in other videos. So, like a parent who recognizes that we train our kids to do right things, but then recognize ultimately they're going to have to make those choices in the times when those choices present themselves, and we won't be there at every instant to make sure that they choose wisely, this is what we can also expect of the divine. The free will defense has lots to recommend it. It does seem to give us a way of making sense of moral evil that doesn't require God to be allowing evil as such, but instead simply allowing the possibility of evil insofar as our choices are genuine. However, this also has some problems, because although it does seem to make sense now of the suffering involved in murder or sexual assault or cheating or stealing, all these sorts of actions, it doesn't seem to explain diabetes and cancer and viruses and even mosquitoes. What do we do with all that natural evil? It seems like the free will defense can address part, but not all, of the human condition. As such, I think that it is a resource and something worth taking very seriously, but it's not adequate all the way down. And so therefore, tomorrow, we're going to look at one further option, an anti-theodicy option, whereby the very attempt to give some sort of justification of God in the face of evil might be a mistake. I'll see you then, unless a piano falls on our heads.